for today's video because I am doing a Valentine's Day video, as you can tell by the title. I had so much fun making this video and all these fun DIYs and treats and stuff. I just love making these types of videos, and I know a lot of you guys like them too, so I really hope you enjoy this. This video is a DIY Valentine's Day gifts and treats. It includes some gifts you can make for your friends, family, special ones, if you know what I mean, or also even for yourself. Also, I don't know if you guys remember, but I designed a Squirt with Mode, and this is the last week that it will be on sale, so if you want to get it, it's only $10, free shipping everywhere, and the money goes to St. Jude's Children's Hospital, which is a great cause. So if you want to get a super cute squirt that goes to charity, please click the link down below, and it'll only be out for one more week, so please make sure to take advantage of that. So I think that's all I have to say for this intro. I really hope you guys enjoy the video, and let's go ahead and get started! For these delicious DIY pink velvet donuts, you're going to start out with a tablespoon of cocoa powder and put that into a little bowl along with half a tablespoon of pink or red food coloring, and you're just going to want to stir this all together until it's kind of like a little paste, as you can see right here, and it's going to be really thick and chunky. Next, just take 1 cup of flour and put that into a big bowl along with a teaspoon of baking powder and also 6 tablespoons of sugar. And after that, you're just going to take a spoon and mix all of that together until it's fully incorporated. Next, take 6 tablespoons of buttermilk, and if you're like me and you don't have any buttermilk at home, I'm going to leave a little substitute in the description down below that you can use instead, and it works fine. Also, add in your little red food coloring cocoa powder paste and 1 egg, 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract, and 1 tablespoon of melted butter. And then just take a blender and blend all that together. And can we just take a minute to look at how beautiful this pink color is? I love it. Anyway, then you're going to take a little mini donut maker. You could also just bake these in a donut pan in the oven at 375 until they're golden brown. But I had this cute little donut maker and I got it from Walmart for like 20 bucks. I'm gonna try to link it down below. So just go ahead and take some spoonfuls and put it inside. And after a few minutes, you can open it up and you have some beautiful, adorable little mini pink velvet donuts. So you're just gonna continue this process until you have finished up using all of your batter. Now, you can't have donuts without frosting, so I just made a quick little batch of frosting. I didn't use any exact measurements. I just put in a few spoonfuls of powdered sugar, a spoonful of cream cheese, and also some milk, and I just mixed it up until it tasted good. So all you're gonna do is just take your little mini donuts and dip them into your frosting, and mine was a little bit chunky, but it still worked out fine. It's all good. And after that, I just sprinkled on some red or pink sprinkles. You could use whatever kind you want here. And that is all you have to do for these donuts. I think they turned out so cute. They taste amazing. My brother and his friend ate like all of them, and I understand why, because they were so good. I think this would be a perfect gift to maybe bag up and give to one of your friends or your boyfriend or really anyone on Valentine's Day, and you should definitely try these out. We're so dysfunctional, but still inseparable. Yeah, we just never. Moving on to our DIY heart candle, I just started out with a little candle and it has some bedazzles on it from a past DIY, but you could use a plain one if you would rather do that. So first you're just going to take a piece of tape. I used some cute pink washi tape because I thought it was festive. And you're going to tape some string or twine onto your candle and just start wrapping it around a bunch of times until you have as much as you like. I wanted to have a pretty thick amount of string around my candle, so I just did that. And once you have as much as you want, you can just cut that up and secure it with some glue or tape. Next, I found these super cute heart stickers in the dollar section at Target, so I just put one of those onto the candle on the string, and I think it added a lot of spice. And then I just took some cute Valentine's Day paper that actually came with the heart stickers that I just used, and I wrote a little punny saying on there. It says, "You light up my world," because, I mean, it goes with a candle. I just thought it was funny. I don't know, it might be weird. And I just cut the paper into the shape of a gift tag and hole punched it on the side. And then I took some string, put it through the hole punch, and then taped it onto my candle. Obviously, glue would work better here, but I went the laser out and just did some good old washi tape. And that is your completed candle. I think it is so cute. I think it'd be a perfect gift for one of your friends, and it's just adorable, perfect for room decor, and you can basically find every single material in the dollar section. Moving moving on to my favorite DIY in this entire video. First, you're going to start out with some felt. I am using some heart felt from Target, and I just traced out a little owl shape. I freehanded this. You could use a template if you really wanted to. And then I just cut out my owl shape. You want to make sure to cut through two layers of felt so that you have two pieces in the end. Next, I just traced out two little half circles onto a different color piece of felt, and I cut both of those out, and these are actually the little wings for our owl, and I also hot glued those on. You could use craft glue or really anything, but I thought hot glue is the easiest. And I also cut out little circles for the eyes with black and white felt, and I just glued those on as well, along with a little orange beak and a little heart for the belly. And once you have decorated the front part of your owl, you can go ahead and hot glue it to the back side of the other piece of felt we cut earlier, but make sure to leave a hole at the top to spoon in a few spoonfuls of rice. This is what's going to absorb the heat to keep your hands warm, which makes them hand warmers, and then you can just go ahead and seal that off with some hot glue. As you can see, I made another one to go along with it, and I am seriously obsessed with these little owls. I think they are so adorable, and they're super festive for Valentine's Day as well. And to make them effective as hand warmers, all you have to do is put them in the microwave for 10 to 20 seconds, and then you have some little owls to keep your hands warm in the winter. You could give these little owl hand warmers to your friends, your family, or even someone special in your life like your girlfriend or boyfriend. To make a DIY gumball machine, you're going to start out with a little flower pot and some red or pink paint, really whatever color you want, but I just chose pink because it was festive. And all you're going to do is just paint your entire flower pot with the color paint of your choice, and also go ahead and paint a little flower pot holder, which is shown here. These are sold where the flower pots are as well. And I had so much fun decorating my little gumball machine. I took some pink puffy paint and lined the edges, and I also took some of those dollar store stickers that I showed earlier in this video and just stuck some of those on. And I also painted a little ball. You could use a marble or a bouncy ball or even a wooden ball from the craft store, and go ahead and hot glue that on to the little flower pot holder, and also hot glue on a little glass jar. You can find these at Michael's for super cheap as well, and fill that with whatever kind of candy you or whoever you're giving it to loves. I decided to fill mine with some Valentine's Day M&Ms. I think gumballs would be ideal, but I couldn't find those. And that is all you have to do for your gumball machine. I think this would be a perfect gift for any candy lover on Valentine's Day. It's also great room decor. It's really unique and creative, and I'm sure anyone you give it to is going to love it. This last DIY, I feel like doesn't even classify as a DIY because it's so easy to make, but they still taste amazing, so I wanted to include it. All you're going to do is take some little Teddy Grahams, and this reminded me of my childhood. Let me know in the comments down below if you guys ate Teddy Grahams or if you eat them now, because they're amazing. And I just took some melted chocolate and dipped some conversation hearts into the chocolate, and then while it was still wet, I stuck it onto a little Teddy Graham, and when it's finished, it looks like the Teddy Graham is holding a little heart. And that is all you have to do. I just made a bunch of them. It'd be perfect to bag up and give to one of your friends on Valentine's Day. And I know it sounds like a weird combination, but these actually taste so good together, and they're just adorable. I mean, look how cute they are. So you guys should definitely try them out because they're so easy to make. Today's video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. Please make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe down below. Also, let me know in the comments what your favorite DIY gift or treat in this video was. And if you make any of these DIYs from the video, please make sure to tag me on Instagram or Twitter or anything, and I will like your picture or your post or anything like that. Please make sure to check out the website where my skort is sold, and also where my Mini Lucy shirts are sold, because there are also some very exciting new shirts on there. So I think that's all I have to say for this video. Thank you guys so much again for watching. I love you so much, and I'll talk to you in my next video.